Hi everyone, my name is Dmitry, I'm an electronic SMT process engineer. In this video, I'll tell you about methods used for cleaning printed circuit boards after soldering, what cleaning liquids and equipment are best to use, and how to clean PCB boards to achieve high quality results without contamination or white or gray residues. Watch the video until the end, it will be interesting, let's go. Some cleaning methods are suitable after PCB repairs where localized cleaning is required. Other methods are perfect for mass electronic PCB productions where removing soldering flux and residues is necessary, but if it's cheap electronics, it's not necessary. Of course, effective flux removal can only be achieved when using high-quality soldering materials, whose cleaning results can be predicted. In case we are using unknown chemical soldering flux or cheap materials, guaranteed results are difficult to achieve. For every chemical and organic contaminant, a corresponding solvent and cleaner are necessary. This is important if you plan to apply protective coating afterward. For protective coating, the cleanliness of printed circuit boards is crucial for good adhesion. In this case, adhesion, this is penetration ability between coating material and PCB. Which liquids and sprays work well for cleaning PCB boards after repair? Of course, first and least, it's a FluxOFF. I use FluxOFF for any PCB repair around 20 years. It easily cleans soldering area and can be wiped with a lint-free cloth. The lint-free cloth is excellent because it doesn't leave any cloth residues on components and board which could conduct electricity. I know other cleaners and spray on the market include tech spray, MG chemicals, Electrolube. There are other cleaners as well, but sometimes they can be difficult to obtain. What cleaning liquids did I use for manual cleaning and when I need to clean full printed circuit board? Some time ago, for cleaning small batches, I used Vigon AFM, a special cleaning liquid in 1 liter bottle. I would fill two small containers with cleaning liquid. In first container, I would soak PCB for 5 minutes and then I clean with ESD brush, clean both sides of PCB. Afterward, I transfer PCB to second container with cleaning liquids and rinse PCB for 1 minute. And results were excellent, without any residues, very clean. If you can't find Vigon AFM on the market, I prepared small list for you guys. First, MicroCare Flux Remover. Second, Chemtronics Flux Remover ES132 in 1 gallon, but we need to prepare this liquid. Dilute 1 to 10 with distillated water. And third, we can use any liquids like a FluxOFF. The problem with many industrial cleaning liquids is their effective cleaning temperature is around 50 degrees of the Celsius or 122 degrees of Fahrenheit. That makes manual cleaning difficult at room temperature. For a small batch of soldered PCB, you can use aerosol spray, but we will need to rinse more thoroughly and streaks may still remain on PCB. Streaks can be removed with lint-free cloth. Now let's talk about more advanced budget cleaning methods. For daily cleaning of 10 to 50 PCB, two bubble baths work well. The size of the bath can vary, but you can find right volume depending on your need. PCBs are vertically placed on the basket. The essence of bubble cleanings is small bubbles in the liquid. Small air pipes with many holes runs along the bottom of the bath, and the compressor pump air through it like an aquarium. The bubbles gradually dissolve the dirt, but most importantly, the bubbles create movement of liquids inside the bath. That helps to wash out the remains of soldering flux from under microcircuit and other components. In that case, the liquid temperature should be around 50 degrees of the Celsius of 122 of Fahrenheit. You need necessary to monitor of cleaning liquid temperature, as low temperature reduces the cleaning efficiency and high temperature can cause the cleaning liquid to decompose. In the first bubble bath, you can use liquid cleanings like Vigon US, Vigon A250, Vigon FA Plus, Circlean SC2500, Chemtronics ES132, Aquinox or Ionox. In the production unit, carefully select the cleaning liquid based on your equipment and types of soldering flux you are cleaning. Heat the liquid, turn on the compressor to supply air, and immerse basket with vertically positioned PCB into the liquid. The cleaning time, 10 minutes. After cleaning, remove basket from first bath and leave it over the bath for 2 minutes to allow exit liquid drain back into the bath. This is important to prevent transferring cleaning liquid to the second bath. For the second bubble bath, use distillated water. The temperature remains the same at 50 degrees of the Celsius or 122 degrees of Fahrenheit. Also with bubbles and a 10 minutes time. The task of second bath is rinsing. You need to rinse off all the residues, including cleaning liquids from first bath. After rinsing, let the basket stand above the bath for 2 minutes, allowing the water drain back into the bath. The third step is drying. Usually, drying is performed in drying ovens at a temperature 60 degrees of Celsius or 144 degrees of Fahrenheit for 1 hour. Forced drying is necessary because water may remain between SMD components, deep components, and PCB board. When you're working with electronic PCB, use ESD gloves and USD wrist straps to prevent static electricity damage to PCB and to avoid leaving fingerprints on PCB. Right now, I want to tell you about distilled water for rinse and for preparing cleaning liquid. Remember that not all distilled water in the stores are really distilled, even if it's written on the label. You need distilled water without any additives, just H2O. Really distilled water, not cheap. Try to find in Google Chem World. If you are engaged in cleaning electronics on a regular basis, it is cheaper to buy industrial distiller to obtain distilled water. Distilled water does not conduct electricity because it does not contain salt or any minerals. Really distilled water have high resistance around 18 megaohms per centimeter. Understanding the level of water pollution is based on this principle. When the conductivity of water falls below 4 megaohms per centimeter, it needs to be replaced since the water is saturated with pollutant ions. Remember that you can't use tap water since it is saturated with many minerals and salts. You can measure the resistance with TDS meter. A TDS meter will help you to understand what kind of water is in front of you. Drinking distilled water on a regular basis is not advisable because distilled water does not contain helpful minerals and salt. Distilled water have free ionic bonds and these help to attached to this molecule any minerals and salt in your bodies and wash out. This is the essence of rinsing in distilled water. Ions of pollutant attached to free H2O bonds, improving the quality of washing. The more ions of salts, minerals, soldering flux residues and pollutants attached to water molecule, the lower the resistance of the water and the higher the ability to conduct electricity. And that is why it is useless to use tap water for washing PCB. The ionic bonds in it are already occupied by salts and minerals. You can make it worse for PCB and sediment will appear white or gray coating on PCB. I know you want to ask, what about cleaning with isopropyl alcohol? Using isopropyl alcohol for cleaning PCB boards can cause the appearance of white and gray coatings. Since organic alcohols copes well only with organic contaminants, resins, fats, oils, and alcohols copes very poorly with chemical contaminants, such as cheap chemical soldering fluxes without organics, water-based fluxes with precipitation of salts, other salts that arise during the reaction with fluxes and metals, corrosion residues and copper oxides. After the isopropyl alcohol dries on the PCB board, you will see white or gray coating that is difficult to remove without mechanical cleaning. The white or gray coatings causing conductivity and current leaks on the PCB. Visible white or gray coating can somehow be removed, but the coating that has formed under components and microcircuit is almost impossible to remove. You need to resolder. I don't recommend isopropyl alcohol for repairing works for creating electronics on the production. Write the comments how often you use isopropyl alcohol, how often you see white and gray coatings, and what you do for cleaning this board. I'm not finishing yet, and right now the time for like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you. What about ultrasonic cleaning? I don't use ultrasonic and don't recommend it. In the next video, I explained you why I don't recommend the video, not right now. Make sure to subscribe this channel if you don't want to miss this video. Next topic about industrial cleaning system. In industrial manufacturing, using the same methods, cleaning, rinsing, drying. For everyday big batch of soldered printed circuit boards on manufacturing using conveyor cleaning system or spray liquid cleaning system. Spray cleaning machine is more common on the world with water-based cleaning liquids. The principle of spray cleaning machine is very similar to a dishwasher, but the system is more complex. I hope this video has helped you understand the nuances of cleaning PCB. Leave your comments below about cleaning methods you use. Be sure to subscribe this channel and hit the bell. In description on this video you can find links to my Instagram, my Telegram channel, to my website with Soldering Flux and my new website with search system for electronic manufacturers. Thanks you for watching. Bye bye.